They tell me it's Wednesday, and that can only mean it's time for World War Wednesday with Dan and Daniel.
Hello!
Hello!
So,
we're back.
Yes. And yes. You voted for Kaiserreich, so...
Kaiserreich it is.
But we didn't want to play the Kaiserreich.
No. Well, Daniel did.
Well, no. We want to play the Italian state. But they're not fully finished yet. So we asked the dear people of Kaiserreich, which nations do you think we should play as? And since we had a hat, which apparently doesn't want to be on my head, but
no,
anywhere
I mean,
else.
The, for Kaiserreich, the symbol is not really accurate either.
But it's a nice hat.
Yes.
So we want to play Russia.
Yes.
And it's hell.
Nope.
It's really hell. I tried it out a tiny bit here so we wouldn't be completely unprepared. It blows up.
Oh, I was settling in for like a nice peaceful time. You know?
Yeah.
Maybe using some diplomacy on some neighbors, get some stuff, but...
Yeah, no.
Right.
Yeah, it's kind of hard actually. So I'll be very focused on the game itself and we'll see. And what mod early bird beard? It's Kaiserreich.
Yes.
So, time to set up our nation. We'll play a bit slower this time and just let everyone... let's take off this video.
it doesn't work with the earphones.
It will be a bit slower so everyone will like see the history behind this and all the cool events and how the entire mod works more.
Yeah, didn't actually explain. So, if you haven't seen us showing Kaiserreich before, because we only did a really fast, quick playthrough, and... it's basically a mod where it's alternate history in the premises. Germany basically won World War One, so things are quite different. And this time, neither of us have played this very much, so we don't know exactly what to expect. But we're going to try and take it a bit slower this time, a bit more carefully, and read through what happens and stuff like that, rather than the last playthrough where we kind of rushed to see how far we could get in 1 hour.
But now we'll probably do this for one, maybe two, or... Two, three, maybe?
We'll see.
So,
Let's play as long as it's interesting.
Yes, and as long as you want us to continue playing.
Yeah, and this is alpha, so if we run into bugs, it's...
Totally not our fault, also, which is nice to say.
Yeah, that's awesome, for once. So if we run into bugs, we don't have to be ashamed.
Hashtag blame cards.
But it does mean that if we run into some stuff, we might work around it with cheats and stuff like that.
Yeah. But it's a very normal setup that I do. Nothing really... Really strange, but one thing that's kind of weird, we can pick no natural focuses from the beginning.
Yeah, we have minus 198.
Yes, that too.
Political
but everything
power.
Is blocked off because it's very unstable in Russia here.
Yeah, can we look at some of the political factors here? So
they will disappear very soon because everyone dies.
What, so I'm not going to get my peaceful years?
No, unfortunately not. And seems like...
Actually, how long is that flag going to stay accurate now?
A couple months, maybe?
Yeah.
You have to wear this like a cape, as Ilya does.
Thank you, Björn.
Thank you.
So, Kaiserreich Alpha 0.2. Thank you, Kaiserreich team. Great job, lined on the shoulder of giants. Okay, troubled history.
I like this. It gives you some insight into what actually happens here.
So, at the Congress of Omsk, April 1919, the White Generals agreed to form a united political front behind Alexander, slaughtering name, and the remaining forces of the provincial...
Kerensky, it's the guy who runs our country.
Yeah, but... Yeah. The united White Forces, joined by Republic of Finland, made a considerable gains, but the Red Army was still too strong and well-placed, dominating the Russian industrial heartland and transportation networks. But soon, the German Empire, fearing success of a dangerous ideology, decided to intervene on behalf of the Whites, which sounds very wrong, really.
kind of a German thing, I guess.
Yeah, but not World War One. Remember, this was supposed to be...
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point.
In exchange for recognition of the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk.
I'm probably butchering that too.
Anyway, named that too. Yeah. By September 1921, both Moscow and St. Petersburg had fallen to the White Forces, and a new Russian Republic was established in the old imperial capital of St. Petersburg. For the past 15 years, the leading parts of the Social Revolutionaries and Cadets have governed in an uneasy coalition under Kerensky. maintaining power through electoral manipulation and lack of serious political opposition. And now the thing, where are we today?
More specifically, I'm going to assume serious political opposition.
Yeah, maybe. More specifically, 1936 is yet another dark time for Russia. Do you hear the music?
Yeah. Yeah, Kaiserreich has a separate mod for music. So if you're downloading Kaiserreich, make sure you get the music mod as well.
Is it fine for you in the stream? Like, good volume? Awesome.
It's kind of amazing music.
Okay. Yet another dark time for Russia.
Yes. The recent maybe we can fix that.
Yeah. The recent... Oh, well.
Maybe.
We'll try. The recent decision of the German Empire to push forward payments and reparations, those bastards, agreed upon the Brest-Litovsk Peace Treaty, is forcing Russia to enact drastic reductions in budget for armed forces and existing social system. Such financial austerity, even if needed, combined with stagnation of economy, have brought the ire on the nation, pushed country on the verge of general unrest. With the government barely controlling the streets of Moscow and St. Petersburg, let alone the rest of the country, things are looking bad for Russia. However, other political forces are growing and considering whenever it's time now for a change, so that the country may once again assert its power in the world.
Excellent.
Long live Russia. One.
Indivisible.
Yeah.
Indivisible. I'm just going to say it now. I think the Tsar is going to save our bacon.
You think so?
Yes.
We'll try.
Yes.
We'll try to reestablish the stardom. We can't hear the music.
Just up the music a bit, then, yeah, and we'll see. It's gonna be very loud for some, but I think it's fine. It's nice music.
Yeah, it's very epic music. With choir.
Yeah, it's really, really fitting.
Yeah.
So, the Russian Constitution of 1918. This country. So, a constitution we signed in 1918.
Yeah. So, how come you're pulling all your forces inland?
Yes, I want to gather up, because it might happen something around this area, and I just want to gather my army in one position. And I'm probably also going to disband the 30 divisions or so, something of it.
Yeah. I mean, what is our army like? Is it in
horrible
shambles?
Shambles, not enough equipment, not really good templates.
So everything's on like 30%?
Yeah.
Ouch.
That's why I'm only producing infantry weapons right now.
And submarines.
Yeah, apparently. Yeah, I should actually do like this, because I don't care about navy right now, I need convoys. And here's our fleet. We need to sign, let's see.
Oh. It's cool, custom generals. Well, admirals, I guess.
Yeah, I guess we could put him, because we're probably going to build some carriers later.
Are you worried there's going to be a civil war that takes out our navy?
What? No, definitely not. And here, one Russian, most superior political, had passed away. So, one cool thing is, he will also disappear from here. Let's see if he already disappeared.
Heart attack.
Boris.
Oh, actually, this is interesting because...
A symbol for Russia's tradition and continuity. Workers' demonstration, minus 20 political power, so almost everything we have gained.
What we missed, though, is that here's the big news, how they ended up.
Yes.
The assassination of Kerensky, so I guess he's gone when we close this one. Yeah. Oh, an unknown gunman stepped from the streets and shot the president and his chauffeur with a Mauser C96.
It feels very World War I-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Goodbye.
Oh dear.
Update. The Senate is now in control.
Oh.
And
for how long?
Did?
Has this unlocked?
No, not yet. It's another event a bit later. So, National Focus Bypass, President Kerensky. Huh? Assassination of President Kerensky. So, it's. Even if he wasn't the most popular man, he still held the country together.
Okay, so the Senate are discussing a possible replacement.
Yes, how barbaric. That's
yes.
That's, here, they also talked about a lot of people thinking about, I can take power.
Yeah.
And here we get the choice. So the left, SR, Mexican secure a majority in the Duma. Mm-hmm. Marshal Dwensky declares martial law and dissolves the Duma. Wrangel's officers seize the apparatus of the state, and aristocrat and the Senate elect Grand Duke Dmitry as new president. We don't want a president, and we also lose 200% political power.
Ouch.
200.
I was going to go for that.
Yeah.
I got to think.
Here we lose 300. Here we only lose 100. And here we only lose 160.
Okay, so
like
which of these guys is the least bad? I mean,
yeah, but you wanted the Tsar. Then we kind of have to go for the minus 300.
Yeah. Let me put it this way. Anything but communism is my baseline.
Okay, that's interesting. But I think we kind of need to grab just... Wrangel's officer seized apparatus status. We will go minus 300 political power.
Yeah.
But we will not be communist.
I mean, we're already...
This hurts me as a player.
We can always get it back somehow. Yeah. I hope.
Well, we'll see. So now we are under Wrangel. We have the nationalist populist in power. But here's one interesting mechanic. So we have medium part popularity, which grants us 0.5 political power.
Yeah.
We have average stability. But since we are minus in political power, this will probably go down.
Yeah.
And so probably go down all the way to disaster.
Exactly.
Sooner or later.
So what happens?
So we have to fix it as
events.
Quickly as possible.
Yeah. Yeah.
And one thing, one way we can do it is, if you check here, he's leader of natural populist, he's apparent autocrats and natural populist. So if we could do everything perfectly, we would change out these two.
Yeah.
Like, even if he's not the best one, he's still aligned with us. Otherwise, these two might get bad events or promote their own political power, which means this would reduce, this would be even worse, and we would gain even less part popularity. So if we can, we would like to purge these two.
Yes. Send them on a vacation to Siberia or something like that.
Something like vacation.
Okay, so.
So, even more. And yeah, low part popularity. I was waiting for this. That's the perfect thing. So, Edward the Eighth crowned as King of Britain. Mm. And here.
So the Germans are making us pay.
Yeah, with 400 political power.
Ouch.
For 365 days.
Inflation's never hurt anyone. Yeah. I'm sure we can fix this.
And what's even better is they restrict even more of our consumer goods. Oh. And if you check here, we don't have the best Soviet threat, divided military staff, divided naval staff, political instability, and positive measures. So everything is kind of
on the
bad.
Good side, though, our leader has a very piercing gaze.
Yeah.
Which
he looks in my... And low stability. So that restricts even more of our consumer goods. And now we're producing with 9 factories. So, right. Our second in command.
Interesting.
Wrangel secret cables or extremist officers control the streets. All senior Duma duties are under arrest, waiting liquidation. And communication lines are close monitored. So, the most promising. Removes all head of these. Pavel, which grants head of government. Okay, he's with us. He's not with us. He's not with us. He's not with us.
But he's a flamboyant aristocrat, though.
Yes.
He'll bring glamour to the dictatorship. You know what I'm going to vote for, right?
Yeah, but I'm kind of not going to agree with you because we kind of need that political power. Because
think of the glamour.
Look, low stability.
Ouch.
Look what happens at disaster.
Our nation gets
destroyed. So I would rather not put this because if Soviet Union would suddenly spawn, we have 5% national unity.
I guess. Although, imagine how glamorous we would look burning. Okay, let's go with the same choice.
So, that should be switched out. Oh, wait, no. He was all bit. Yeah. Even with this, we want a Tsar aristocrat. Oh, God. This mod is... It's really cool, though. They have created this entire new world, basically.
Yeah, I feel like you probably should be like reading the wiki a bit ahead of time to know everything that's really happened.
Yeah,
I like that there are the pop-up events kind of explain your situation.
Yeah, so
but there's so much lore.
So the Berlin Stock Exchange stopped. So it's basically the Great Depression, and as our nation wasn't destroyed enough, we have black money now and failure of bombing plot.
That's good.
Yeah, but minus 60 political power.
All right.
And now, our first natural focus is finally unlocked.
Woo!
So, with revolutionary movements active throughout Russia, some members of Duma are suggesting it's time to complete reorganization of an internal police on basis of the old Tsar secret police, the slaughtering name, to maintain law and order in Russia. This organization will hunt down any radical radical elements and re-educate them to respect the Russian state.
Excellent. I think re-education is what we need here.
Yeah, definitely. They have had their free will for far too long. And here we have, well, Afghanistan declaring war on India.
Oh, yeah.
It feels weird. It's like, why would they do that?
Yes.
And you can see our troops are slightly Japanese sometimes.
Yeah, that's an interesting known bug.
So as long as you agree to the workers' demands, you should be fine. Yeah.
Good.
Like we
will
agree. agree with workers and their demands. I don't know.
I bet their demands are unreasonable.
Yeah, like freedom and stuff like that. Yeah. Downfall instability, very low stability. Dun 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 dun.
Dun dun. What's our rightmost thing here?
Decisions.
Aha. Uh-huh.
But right and now Russia we have no decisions. And now we have disaster.
Oh,
Black Monday in Russia.
See, you should have let me have the flamboyant guy. It would have looked glorious doing it anyway.
And now Ivan Pavlov's die. Let's see who it is. Okay, no. Oh, okay, it could be it's one other minister.
It's someone
minister.
You haven't picked yet.
Yeah. Bye-bye. So, general strike. So, we just have a couple things now. We have the general strike. We have the Russia is hit by Black Monday. The measures. The political instability. Divided staff. Divided military staff. The Soviet threat. We have low party popularity. And disaster going on. So, our nation is kind of...
Surely it can't go worse.
Of course not, because now we need to negotiate with the strikers.
Hopefully our secret police can help here.
But one thing I really notice is minus political power and consumer goods are restricted. Mm-hmm. And here, plus political power, and we get a worse penalty.
Hmm.
But our nation is already so bad, we don't actually get worse by picking this. We are already in a complete meltdown. So it's like, yeah. Okay, we make a deal, but...
And we get some political power.
Yeah.
Sure.
Like, we are producing none, because it's completely gone. We can't build any buildings, because we don't have any consumer goods. So picking, like, making an agreement with them will just not break our nation, because it's already broken.
Yeah.
French loyalist, restore monarchy. Oh.
No. Excellent pipe. Yeah.
Now they return. At least the general strike is gone. God.
Yeah. Speaking of monarchies, for people who haven't tried Kaiserreich, maybe
here we go.
Oh.
So we lose 40 right away.
Yeah.
But we gain 5% more, which means, like, we basically just need to raise this as much as possible.
Yeah.
Because now we only gain 0.35 when we have one. So, yes, a bad right now, bad just now, but hopefully. Yeah. There isn't one hidden that is like game over or something.
No. Should we ask the chat which capital to go for?
Ooh, I didn't get this event yet.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Okay, let the chat decide.
All right.
Petrograd or Moscow?
Yes. Post one or two. One is Petrograd.
Two is Moscow. So people don't actually have to write. That's pretty smart.
Yeah.
It can get worse. Says the revolution.
No.
That revolution, it can get worse. Okay, people are still writing us everything.
I think Petrograd's winning.
Yeah, it looks like it.
I think so.
That's a bit different too.
Yeah.
We have a lot of viewers right now.
Yeah. Not sure how many actually.
Move capital to Petrograd.
Let's go with that. Hopefully Finland is not in a messy mood with us.
Well,
since you moved your entire army inland.
Yeah, I might have just done that a bit too much. Oh, right, I never reorganized this. I'm going to take a couple of seconds, just talk about something cool.
Yeah. Yeah, while Daniel reorganizes this, I feel like I should have maybe had my own screen.
The Dev
Diary?
I
could have pointed out some of the other nations, but let's talk about the Dev Diary instead. We had some sickness on the team, so we had to scramble a bit for the diary. That's why I was so late today. But hopefully it's cool anyway. So what we wanted to write about this week was kind of what we've been doing optimization AI-wise, but because of change of plans, we ended up talking about balance stuff we've been working on instead. So we've done quite a lot of rebalancing for industry. One of the things that we always wanted to have was the efficiency of production lines mattering more. So rather than being a linear gain now, it's much more fall-off curve. So it's going to take a lot longer to hit maximum levels. Any text that affect retention is going to be more important, and it's going to be more like a much more interesting choice whether to switch or not. Now the big thing is infrastructure is going to be affecting building speed, which means that certain states have now gained a lot in value. Those national focuses you might have never cared about that are about building infrastructure and are super sweet. Yeah, so that really affects your strategy on where to build and if you want to protect certain areas, where to build infrastructure rather than just being do I have enough to, you know, supply my front towards someone.
Okay.
And now Daniel's back.
So basically, we are missing so much equipment. I just reorganized. I deleted all the units with very low equipment and kept the ones with higher. Because the higher equipment they have, which means basically more trained men. So I, first of all, none of the trained people were disbanded. I disbanded the cavalry, which is kind of not a very good division right now, if you check. Yeah. And they also have artillery I wanted.
What are you producing though? Should we maybe step right down our infantry equipment? Or is that basic level? Yeah, because you're minus 40k, like, because there's a base level.
Oh, you meant to
yeah, maybe
the bad
even
one.
Even like, because you're minus 40k, like,
we only have 10% efficiency right now. We're producing one every day.
Yeah.
So I don't think it would matter that much when we're missing 35,000 equipment. I don't know what's actually going on now. For me, the war has happened. Happened right now. I was at war with some.
But
right
did
now.
Did you make a deal with the? Oh, so potential bombing. I mean, did you make a deal with the workers when you tried it?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I wonder why haven't.
Well, it's probably on the random, so you can't game it too much by saying moving your
army
inland.
It actually a while before the war actually begins with Soviet Union, so you actually have some time to move back your army and stuff like that. Yeah. I just did it as a...
Yeah.
And right, we can't continue anymore with national focuses because there's nothing we can take right now.
All right. What are they actually
Russia's
blocked by right now?
Different events happening. All like right. Here, we need to be at peace, but someone has to take in over the power.
Yeah.
The same thing with all of these.
Mm-hmm.
This one is, well, event-based too.
Yeah.
And yeah, so basically it's event-based. We're waiting for bad stuff to happen in our nation, which is kind of sad, actually.
I'm waiting for good stuff to happen.
And so the Arab Congress.
All right. The Arab revolt in the Weltkrieg was a failure, mostly the defeat of the Entente. All right. Yeah, but it's not up to us. Initial stabilization.
Oh, yeah.
Nice. See, I told you good stuff would happen.
Did you say anything?
maybe.
So here, this is the thing I'm talking about. Yes, it's because of one of these guys.
Yeah.
So either we allow them to, well, increase their party popularity, or we use 40 to just say, no, screw you. And I really want to pick this one now.
Yeah, let's
because
go
we
for
only
it.
Have 37% right now.
Yes.
Mm. Ouch. So all that we gained is now gone once again. So, remilitarization of all... God, this will hurt so much. Like
we
this...
got some tech at least.
Yes. And, well, that's one thing. But, like here in France... Yeah, divided military staff. So we can't pick anything. So I would just recommend myself to pick more industry.
Yeah, but we don't... Isn't it going to be a war soon? We can maybe take some of the passive attack bonuses?
Ahead
how
of time.
That? Oh,
everything.
It's ahead of time,
and,
right.
Well, we could do this one, but if you check how
can
much...
Can you even afford artillery?
We're missing 148.
Yeah.
And here's one very interesting thing. And it seems like I lost the flag.
Oh yeah.
Well, we are not.
Well, it's not accurate anymore now. Yeah. So,
status of the Orthodox Church. So, under leadership of vocal patriarch Krill, is demanding a clarification of its legal status in the Russian Republic. He wants us to pass a constitutional amendment on the issue of our national religion.
So, orthodoxy, or even making it as part of ruling.
100 political power, I like that. We're modern and secular, nothing.
Mm-hmm. And dun, interesting dun, 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 thing happens.
And as you can see, most of these people do not agree with our standards.
No.
So I would probably just say it's our state religion.
Of course, we could be spreading the Orthodox Church by weapon power, right?
State religion, it makes it much easier. Okay, nice. Secular... Lord, there's somewhat back to the game in the chat right now. If we only read the chat more.
Yeah, let's see. Is it like... I think people are going, I don't know.
Patrick is a scumbag. Don't pick three.
Yeah,
three instantly.
Yeah, people are split. Maybe go with state religion.
Yeah.
If you want to be safe, we want some political power.
Like we're not gonna ask at everything, because then we'll be a democracy. We can't be a democracy on stream.
No. Even if we are a democracy, we will not be a democracy.
So deliberately criticize the clergy. Let them shout or. Encourage natural debate on religious matter.
Yeah.
And one more failed bomb. So all that 100 we got is almost
gone.
Can all
those bomb bombs succeed? Is what I wonder.
Probably. I assure you, 68 is old age.
Oh.
I assure you. So,
Bolsheviks.
It's, yeah, him.
All
right. No, it isn't. Maxine. Both just had Alexei in the first name. Elected chairman of the TUC. Ooh. Okay.
Union of Britain. So, does that mean fascism is on the rise in Britain? So here,
what the hell? Like, I got all these events during the Civil War.
Oh.
And I was, like, super happy about this. I was, like, celebrating because look at these units.
So, all female divisions? Wow.
Veterans.
Nice.
I want them as a separate group. They should be commanded by... Do we have a female general?
That would be awesome.
It looks a bit feminine, but hopefully I didn't offend a lot of people right now.
I don't know. Let's take someone who could work, who doesn't have a massive beard or anything like that.
He has a purple background, but he's old. Ooh. He looks badass enough
to
be
a commander. Yeah, but he's
skilled
too.
Okay, let's check on the good one. We could... pick Constantine.
Yeah.
Or Vrangel.
Actually, yeah, let's command ourselves. That's cool.
God division should be under us.
Yeah. So what's the composition? Are they like a regular?
Yeah, they are just 9.
Okay.
But they are the most veteran units we have in our entire army.
Yeah.
Damned socialists. And one more bomb. And we are back at minus 900.
Oh.
Stalled negotiation. We will definitely breach an agreement. But the next one, I'm probably just going to tell them to shut up.
Yeah. Oh. More strikes.
I thought the Star Wars music started playing for 1 second.
Yeah, it's the choir. It's kind of epic.
So,
one more bomb. More minister stuff.
You can now reform the... Oh, so we might be able to actually avoid the entire Soviet threat. I might have accidentally picked one of those options to shut them down, and that created the Soviet Union.
All right.
Political power, yeah, we are going to spend it once again to just beat them down.
More failed bombing plots.
Okay, back at 900.
I'm just happy they're not succeeding.
Yeah. All right, we could reorganize the army right now. So either we go reform the army by him.
Yeah.
Or by Rangel. I'm slaughtering names so hard. Or Makarov. I don't want to do Makarov because
so
that
which
sounds like Call
first
of Duty.
All, which doctrine do you want to go here? Grand Battle Plan?
Yeah, mass assault actually. So that also gives us 145 political power.
Yeah, so that's a bit more. What's the AMO 10?
I don't know actually. Is there a tank? No.
Not unless they made new tanks. Airplane maybe? Nope.
Maybe it's tech that isn't in yet in the game.
Could be a secret one, maybe.
Oh
it's motorized. All right.
We don't know. Yeah, but I'm gonna reform it.
All right. Here.
You can only take one of these plans to reform the army. Choose wisely. Mm. The first event you chose poorly.
No.
Okay, we will have to just trigger.
Question though, I wonder if they succeed if you don't have the secret police like we decided.
Maybe.
To. It could be. Or like they have a higher chance or something.
But I would probably force the workers to like bring down them next time. So
yeah.
I'm just thinking, maybe if we beat Soviet Union down, we won't have the bombing attempts ruining our nations all the time.
We'll see.
Once again, now we're almost back at -1,000.
Yeah. It's all that political power, man.
And low party popularity. So our nation being nice and peaceful.
No. What's the cutoff on the party popularity? Do you have to get above 50 or?
Above 40, I think, for the medium party popularity. Okay. Yeah, 40 to 60%.
But we're not that far off, right?
60 to 80, no. We're at 37 right now.
Yeah.
No national focus.
So maybe
just
next, if
down.
We can give ourselves a little bump.
Yes. Let's keep an eye
and
firm
stuff
eye on
happening
them.
And
yeah, we're producing 2 every day now.
Maybe you should fork off the female divisions to have their own template so we can prioritize them.
No, they are full.
I meant if you start fighting later.
Oh, right. Actually, we can do it
nice
this way.
Boost. Oh, you give them like the elite theater.
Yeah.
Yeah, that works too. I like my little upvote arrow and things. Yeah. 902.
Yes. We can maybe fix this.
Yeah.
Keep
really
lowering your PP.
Music.
Maybe there will be an underflow.
I'm pretty sure I fixed that code. So I don't think it can happen. Maybe.
This music would have been perfect during the war.
Yeah. But it's upbeat.
Yeah. Quick, fast actions.
Yeah.
Fighting in a hard war for survival. Yeah.
But No.
Let them shout.
Yeah, let them shout. Let's give a little rundown some of the other nations for people who haven't seen the mod, since we're waiting on potential issues here.
Yes, so we can begin here.
Yeah.
German Empire,
of course.
Controlled by Wilhelm II.
Of course.
They have victors of the Weltkrieg, so
yeah.
Instead of France.
Yeah. I mean, it is the Kaiser, right?
Yeah.
Fault, right?
Yeah. Well, we have to begin from the start.
Yeah, yeah.
Colonial upkeep, we have... well,
yeah, so they're
operations,
related,
bastard.
Except they're getting good stuff from that
Yeah,
one.
-5% consumer goods.
Yeah.
Improve machine tools. So let's actually do this now, since we can.
Oh, and we have 50% off.
Yeah. So, where should we do here? I would like to go this one, just to fix our land doctrines. We could.
Yeah.
Otherwise, here's infantry weapons, support, mechanized.
But
and
we're almost the infantry one. Is it ahead of time, or is it just research bonus?
Yeah, research bonus.
Yeah, but we're still ahead, you know. We would have to wait for the head of time bonus.
So. I also like this one. 10% recovery rate.
Oh, that's nice.
But first of
maybe go with doctrine if we're not going to get into war right away.
It was one of these that I saw were really nice. Here, training time -20%, so we can just really quickly throw out people if we really have to. And that's also 3% more recruitable population and one more land doctrine.
Yeah,
so I'll just begin with... reorganize this one. So, good.
And
now we don't have the penalty to Germany and they don't have the bonus.
Woohoo! Not that we're gonna attack Germany, right?
Not yet, at least.
I mean, I figured our first step would be to kind of fix all these map issues on the border of Soviet Union.
Yeah,
I mean,
it kind of feels like something we should do. The second American Civil War.
Yeah, this is what happened last time we played Canada, right? And we got involved.
Crisis in Danube.
Oh.
Europe is never going to be calm.
No.
And Pacific States. So, basically everyone is at war with Shadow now. And now, Europe is dying.
Well, you love poets, though.
So it's the Austria-Hungary that is basically at war with everyone here.
Can we? I guess we don't have much support either side with here.
So many cool events right here.
Yeah. I do think it's good that we decided to go with single player for this, because there are so many events in Kaiserreich that I don't think it really comes to its right in multiplayer.
No.
Unless you know like
exactly
all the details, because people are going crazy with us pausing and reading stuff in multiplayer.
Well, they're kind of clicked away anyway, but...
Yeah.
Not crazy, but I kind of want to do this. Our regime is now established throughout the country and a new order is coming into being. However, many wondering how grand Rank's ambition are and
really grand
to the Tsars and old Russian Empire. A clarification in his status needed. It is himself the Grand Leader of Russia, or should invite the legitimate Tsar Kirill to be the national figurehead. Or maybe the Grand Duke Dmitry will be an easier emperor to control. So plus 200 political power.
Does this mean now we can actually pick the
200? Wait. That was much more than 200. That was 500.
But I assume this unlocks national focuses where we can actually pick.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Tsar.
Here. We can pick a couple of them.
Yeah. Maybe while we wait. Oh, actually, we already finished. So.
Yes. Yeah. So, invite the legitimate Tsar. Crown Dmitry as the new Tsar and autocrat. Mm. Wrangel is the new autocrat.
You know me, right?
Well, he can remove, like, all of these actually remove natural spirit Soviet, so we won't actually have a Soviet uprising.
No, that's great.
That's boring. Well, we wanted to fight that hard war.
Well, we can fight everybody else.
Yeah.
So what do we get here from the different Tsars?
If you invite the legitimate Tsar.
I'm looking at Imperial Glory versus a library here, and I'm going like, Glory is pretty good.
Cult of personality.
No, come on. We have the choice of the Tsar or autocrats. We gotta go with Tsar here.
So here we get the voice the voice of the Tsar first. So,
see, the chat is saying invite the true Tsar or we riot.
Neo-Slavism, justify war goal, improve life conditions,
and
imperial glory. Gain snatch spear with grand same majority monthly. Oh, that was boring.
It's still cool. Though.
Right here, we have political instability, remove Soviet threat, minus one of political power. Mm-hmm. We gain 100 political power, so
soon
negates itself.
Catch up.
Movable feast, natural unity, and factory output
10%. Wow, that's really good.
Yeah, slip from the Senate power, plus 100% more, and the Great Library research time, minus 5%. Right now, this sounds much better.
Yeah, I feel like Imperial Glory was a little underselling itself here. But yeah.
And if we pick, him, centralized power plus 250 polit power. Yermama removes yet a grants recruitable population 4%. Hello, Grugi. 200 polit power more and cult of personality 15% national unity.
Man, that's a lot of cool options too.
I don't actually know what to pick.
Okay, maybe the new Tsar? Like.
How about the library? Wasn't it fun? But they have.
Yeah, but the library is full of geeks who can research tanks for us.
Yes, that's true.
So, but I'm kind of going for that. You know,
but here's a lot of political power.
Yeah, but
we would.
It's not every day you get to be the Tsar, though.
He would be the new, or well, autocrat. But
invite
actually, we have some cool text that
actually,
might be able to help us.
People seem to be going for the legit Tsar here.
Can't mangle the wrangle.
Yeah. All right, so
okay, people are same wrangle.
He can be Tsar. If he can be Tsar,
can be Tsar.
If he can become a Tsar, then we're gonna go with that.
Centralized power, cult personality.
Because you know he gets to make state cinema, which is amazing.
Centralized power.
Yeah.
Under one single strong leader.
As long as we can at least call him the Tsar, then I'll be happy.
Okay, everyone is saying. So let's do it now.
All right.
So he wants to take control. And if he can be a Tsar...
It's a bonus.
Definitely. But what do you think we should first do? Kingdom of Ukraine are pretty big, but they're in the alliance with Germany. And that, let's say they can be pretty hard beat.
Yeah.
So I'm
thinking... What about those guys? Cause I have
these
no
two
idea.
First.
Yeah, but which one is the most value to us area-wise? Isn't this area much nicer for the Donkey?
Well, here's a lot more factories, but if we check resources, we have chrome, tungsten, aluminium, steel, and here we have a lot of oil.
Yeah.
Not the biggest one, because that's apparently under you.
Yeah, but we can grab that later.
Yeah. But I think, yeah, the... I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, are they bragging?
Yeah.
Average build.
Destroy them.
We will have to do that. Yes, because they're taunting us with their political stable countries.
Yeah.
But so far, remember, we are producing 19.
Yeah, but we have those two really good divisions.
Yeah.
Well,
they can do everything, of course. So, now with our reign firmly established, we can begin to consider our stance regarding the rest of the world. Russia should start being more active on the world stage, but we're too weak to interfere in the German or Japanese spheres of influence. The Caucasus, bordering the dying Ottoman Empire, is an easy region to subjugate and has a large oil... Exactly what we were thinking.
Yeah, exactly. It's reading our mind.
Yes. Central Asia, okay, with unstable situation of Alasya Orya and the Turkestan seems an even easier target. So the ones, I said, maybe we should
like
go
this.
First.
This is good because...
We
like,
should secure
you know,
these areas before shifting our gaze anywhere else.
Yeah. But this is great stuff because like when you're playing regular Hearts of Iron, you kind of know where you should be going based on history.
Yeah.
So it's great you get these little hints on juicy areas.
Let's show the world our might. Yeah, our might with a billion men just running without guns. They're going with hands first. Beating crap out of them.
No, not believing here, Daniel.
Peter is a fine name for a Tsar.
Yes.
But I just want to double check that... no, wait, he dies.
What? Still though.
But he dies. Minus two on police power. He dies here too.
Yes.
I am Vorsi, the modern... Oh, yeah, he dies.
Yeah, this is...
He dies. I think we got it. Peter is a fine...
Yeah, this is one of those places you can make custom tools.
Be him with a different hat.
As long as the gaze stays there.
A new chairman of committee minister, now that Wrangel is Tsar. Oh, so it's just we get a new leader.
Yeah.
New head of committee and form a new government. Vladimir, I don't trust people called Vladimir. They always like do different kinds of revolutions everywhere.
Yeah.
It would be great if you can put himself as head of...
You know what I'm going to vote for already, aren't you?
The holy man?
No, the guy from the social scene.
But we need to stay with national populist. So my loyal meaning.
Yeah,
I'll
go
pick.
With that. It's always good to have people holding you back. Although I bet he's going to backstab you.
Average part popularity.
Ooh.
So, 0 plus 5, we're only minus 400. So, we can continue here now. Centralized power, 250 political power. But I think they were basically telling us to declare war against them, but we need political power.
Yeah.
Dot, dot, dot.
So, it's going to take a little bit.
I agree with him. Kaiser Rakim, get your shit together. We need new hats.
I don't know. Don't get stuck making hats. Finish all the focus trees first. It's the most important part.
Austrian Hungary, King of Hungary was annexed, so we have the Austrian Empire now.
Yeah.
Wait.
Another civil war in Spain.
Oh, they have done this.
Austrian Empire.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. So it's no longer Austrian-Hungarian Empire, but Austrian, yes.
Yeah, I figured Kaiser would be one of the ones to use the new cosmetic tag names.
Yes, so civil war in Spain. Send material and technical experts, or Spain is of no interest to Russia.
So, probably, like, I think we should get involved, right?
But
we need XP.
We need, no, we don't get that. We send 1,000 manpower and 500 infantry equipment. Yeah, that's true. So actually send it, even though we are basically going to our troops, taking their weapons to send away to Spain.
Yes. That's where it's going to do the most good.
So the Spanish Civil War. Oh God, it's it's a civil war in within the civil war. Maybe.
I think they probably just fired it twice or something. We'll see.
Foundation of the Belgrade Pact. Serbia, Romania, Greece, the three Balkan members of the Entente, all with revanchist views of their own, have recently gathered together. Okay, so
hopefully
they're getting together.
They won't start another world war.
Well,
yeah.
I think they're kind of going to start
another
world war.
Can we look at the active wars? And,
yes.
Threat thing?
Current wars. So
there's
a
lot of stuff going on in the world here.
So the Anglo-Spanish Cartelli-Spanish War, the Cartelli-Spanish War, Italian-Austrian War, Austrian-Montenegrin War, Fourth American Civil War, Austrian-Hungarian War,
yeah.
The Third, Second, and First American Civil War.
The reason those are is because you only can only really have two. So they have several sides in the Civil War.
Still, I kind of like it that it's counted as several Civil Wars.
Yeah.
Concentrated industry. Nice, thank you.
Nice. Construction.
Oh, God. Time always goes so quickly.
Yeah.
Maybe we should go back to 2 hours. But you don't have time.
Today I can't, but maybe for the future?
Maybe, if there's streaming time.
Yeah.
I kind of don't like that. I'm like, why is 8 units here? Oh.
Yeah.
So, centralized power. We're soon plus. Very, very soon plus. And so, because of civil war in Russia. Oh, they must talk about the last
President
one.
President Kerensky did almost nothing to improve their lives. This is true. It's good Rangel is fixing this.
Rangel has an idea. The organization Young Army began militarized asylums and school of children. The coming generation of the Russian people get a chance to improve their lives and become... What will they become?
More Russian? I don't know.
Wait. I can't read this.
Yeah. But nothing bad's ever happened for having militarized the education of children. So
no, never.
Let's go
never.
With that.
Yeah. Prayers for the Tsar.
Thank you.
Political power. A mass dedication to a beloved ruler has been organized in the capital. The patriarch has officially invited the Tsar and members of the family to take part in summer. So, because we made Orthodox the state religion, they are kind of happy with happy with us.
Thanks for that.
And then peasant unrest.
Stupid peasants.
So, were they lying? They organized the rally, but it wasn't really peasant, it was all actors.
I don't know. Can we do anything to them? Oh, we lost. But we are still plus because we got 40.
Yeah. So minus 20.
Look at that. We're actually below. We only have minus 97 now.
Look at the chat for good info. Well, I kind of like going in with not knowing everything. Just see the exciting stuff. And there's nothing we can do. Yes, it is. We can deny it.
I think theoretically Russia is going to be really popular, really powerful unless we screw up. So it's probably good if we screw up a little bit, but it's going to get too easy. Maybe not. They're pretty big.
So, increase in stability.
Yes, hurrah!
Very low stability. So,
and popularity
we're producing
rising.
30 weapons now. 38.
Total need. It's only 31. Yeah. Oh.
And more popularity for R. And the Mass for the Motherland, a small celebration dedicated to prosperity of the Motherland, was performed yesterday in one of our towns. Even though it was very modest scale attendance, it attracted conservatives, media attention. Many common people consider this a visible sign of the church support for the Motherland.
Nice. So we're getting some benefit. I wonder what would happen if we were, you know...
Very bad stuff?
Yeah, probably. Are we missing half the focus tree? Are we missing half the focus tree? Is there a part we totally should be doing?
Oh,
it's under. Oh dear.
I wonder if we could do this from the beginning and we just missed it.
Maybe. Oh dear.
So this was why people were so mad at us.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I totally didn't see that. I suggest maybe putting some kind of connector from the top or something to the mod team so it's like visible.
I was just expecting this to be the Together for Victory stuff.
Yeah.
So I negated it with my eyes. Especially when you're here, you can't even see anything that hints about
More
it.
Importantly, what does the expansionism foreign policy do?
Not even talking about that one.
Yeah, come on.
So the theater expansion constitutes Russia borders are only as safe as distant from our heartland.
True
Every
that.
Neighboring state which is not a puppet of Russia state is such a threat or a target, depending on military and political strength. Needless to say, Abducting politics, yeah. So, yeah, we're going
sounds
that
like
way.
Common sense. So, it's probably where we should be going.
Real politics.
Oh. Yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff down here. Too bad we missed it out initially.
We only have 10 more minutes.
Yeah.
Apparently, or according to some people in Twitch chat, that part of the tree opens up through an event, so you might not have missed it at the start.
Oh, okay. All right, so at least we shouldn't be halfway through it.
Oh, then. It was probably when we got the event to look at the nations down there.
That's assuming Twitch chat knows what they're talking about.
So. Yeah.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, probably. And here, far east direction. Most likely the way.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're going to... I want to finish this still.
Interesting stuff with
I still want to finish this, so we can just have good party popularity. I can actually wait with this one until we actually go to war. But okay, let's finish this one. Make that one, so we continue speed 5. Then pick foreign policy expansionist.
Yeah.
And God is with us, apparently, as this apparently means. Someone
told
me.
I wonder what it means.
And interesting concept. So publishes Principle of Geopolitics. Published in the late 30s. So, yeah.
We might actually go positive during this play session in political power.
And we go to low stability.
Yeah. Oh, our unity is now 45. Or I was going to say we're at 35.
Average stability. Ooh. We're actually gaining some stuff. So, while this one is running, let's see. Research, we didn't miss anything, right? No, we still have. I just want to let the game run while we can look at some of the stuff we can do.
Does this give us any, like, we want to expand, right? So how do we get war goals fast
enough? So it seems like the left one right here, everything right here is if we pick, real politic. And everything right here is if we pick foreign
expansion. Look at this. You can start intervening in some of the other wars as well. Join Entente,
join Middle Europe, form a new global alliance.
Hmm.
Wow.
I don't know how that sounds. Probably like it's going to be difficult.
Yeah. Let's see what we can do otherwise. So Middle East direction, while the game is running, please. Central Asia direction, secure Kazakhstan, Turkistan,
crush Persia.
Government intervention, remove national beginning of stabilization, further stabilization.
Mm.
Nice. Offer Persia protection for recompensation. We need warm waters, crush Persia.
Yeah, but you get a lot of claims here. So that's pretty cool. And Turkey as well.
Crush Turkey. Secure the cradle of civilization.
I like this path.
Yeah. And we can also go right here.
Yeah.
Secures, claim Xinjiang, intervene in Sino-Japanese War. So we have a lot of stuff to do here. Basically declare war. Oh, wait. Wipe Mongolia from the map. Demand on Northern Mongolia.
That's going to be one of those pretty borders thing. I don't know if Mongolia is going to be... Although, who runs Mongolia? It's that amazing guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who was rumored to be... Genghis Khan's
apparently, he never called himself it.
No,
he
was just his followers did.
Yeah. Continuously good. And we have plus right now. Ooh. I think to gain better than average stability... We need over 150, and then it will just trigger, and we get a choice: do we want to increase it or not? And we're definitely gonna increase it.
But it's pretty cool mechanic that they built using this. So it's basically a reason to sit on a bunch of political power. It gives you advantages.
There's nothing we can do. Yes, there is. We spend political power and are still in plus.
Woo.
God, finally.
Now you're gonna start hitting ahead of time here.
I just wish we had a Soviet Civil War. It was kind of fun to play, but we played too well.
Okay, you just lucked out, Daniel. You just lucked out.
No, definitely not. I totally knew that we were going to survive that. So, we did this one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm super happy now. But you can probably delay 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Because then we might actually get... So, potentially increase stability. With the player, we now have a change to improve our stability. Get the highest average stability, you'll have to take...
corresponding law on the stability screen will cost 150 political
power. Okay,
this
is instructions. So it's... Before it was an event that told me... Oh, wait, that's stability. Oh, yeah, before it was an event that said, do you want to do this or not? Apparently they switched it out. At least I'm pretty sure that was how it worked. But yeah, I'm
going
to just pull this up to very good stability then.
Yeah.
Because minus 7% consumer goods, 10% factory output, and 15% natural unity.
Yum.
And we have 60 natural unity now. our nation is really rising from the ashes. It would have been even more rising from the ashes if we had a civil war. But if you are good enough, you can avoid it.
Yeah. Or lucky.
Still 20,000 minus. Oh, we are actually producing good. I actually put some more.
Could have been some one of those bombing attempts that caused the civil war?
Maybe. And now we have very good stability and medium party popularity.
Nice.
I think we did really well, and 4 million manpower is ready
and
to...
And we have eaten half our deficit in infantry equipment.
Yeah. End of the Spanish Civil War, plus 20 political power most likely because we helped them.
Yeah. I mean, it's an art. I don't know if it was worth sending that stuff in hindsight, but...
But well, it was 500. It was great. And 1,000 manpower.
Yeah, and I mean, look at your manpower now anyway.
Yeah.
It's like gigantic.
Let's see. Expansion is a couple more days. Increasing our weapons. Let's see. Industry. No, it's still very hard. I really need my artillery, but I also want to begin with the tanks. Let's begin
with
the
tanks. Are you going to go with heavy tanks?
Yes, I want heavy tanks this time. We always go light, medium. I want heavy tanks.
You realize there's a ton of mountains down there, right?
Yeah, and my heavy tanks can go through mountains because they're heavy enough.
Okay.
Because that's how it works. Have you never heard of it? The heavy tanks crushing mountains.
All right, let's do it. The heaviest division.
Yes.
That should be our target, I think.
Yeah.
Only heavy self-propelled artillery.
Okay, let's see. Can we pick anyone? I don't think so, actually.
No.
Oh, here. We can. But they don't seem to be doing anything right now. It seems like, yeah, still some work to be done. Well, this is very, very early alpha, so... So, add comp... Oh, God.
Well, I guess what they could do is we get rid of the other guys.
Yeah. If anyone is destroying it for us right now. Both of these people are actually kind of bad. Oh, we could pick him, but that's...
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that's still wrong. National populist... Actually, we need to save that political power, maybe, for the Clean War.
Oh, that's true.
Let's see.
Unless, we only get claims, so we're still going to have to justify.
Let's see.
Middle East.
Yeah. Wait, can we even pick that one?
I think so.
No. You have to finish Central Asian directions before taking this one. So I guess we have to do with Central Asian direction first.
Right.
And bring down Kazakhstan first.
Sorry, Kazakhstan.
Where are they? Aren't they in this area?
Am I
completely wrong?
They should be, right?
Yeah. So we have another civil war in this time in Portugal. It seems like the world in, at this year is very, very unstable.
Yeah.
So, I don't think we actually have to go for the mass mobilization. And since we're going for tanks...
Well, if you're going to have your heavy tanks, you're going to have to go deep battle.
Yeah. So, large front operations, that sounds really much like me.
With heavy tanks.
Yeah. And that military high command. Let's see if we can pick anything.
School of maneuver.
Motorized, mechanized.
Who's the most
psychology,
tank boosting
artillery, infantry division. Like, we won't have a lot of tanks in the beginning war, so I kind of want to go for this one or this one at the beginning.
I like that.
Popularity rising.
Artillery attack
excellent.
Is always good.
Yeah, but do we have artillery?
No. I think you're going to have to get it. I mean, I don't think we can have a fully full.
We could pick this one. More organization, more recovery rate, just a general upgrade of our army. To begin with. Let's see. Oh, Alash is Kazakhstan.
Okay. Excellent.
So, I'm gonna take... How many divisions do you have? 89. So, yeah, I'm gonna just take 20 of them, because it's probably gonna be quite horrible in attrition, but there shouldn't be any problem, even if we are this small.
Yeah, make sure our female elite is there.
Yeah, those I will place out manually. And let's just reduce this one to like something like this. And here, under me, you're gonna be under me or under him. No, actually, you're gonna get something special. You're gonna get a blitz order to grab their capital.
Oh yeah.
So basically just go around this and get assigned right here. I kind of want to see, can we modify it?
I like it though, our Tsar is leading them himself.
Three hoorays for our caring Tsar.
Oh. Excellent.
Outraged by the high prices. Oh. I was like, goddamn, this is way too high.
He rode past on the way to the front line.
Actually, kind of fitting that we just moved him. Then was like, oh, I need to eat something. And I was like, goddamn it.
Yeah.
So expensive. So, Central Asia focus.
Secure Kazakhstan. Lots of claims.
14 days. I approve this.
Yeah. Remember, we still have to justify. It's only claims.
Gains an annex war goal.
Oh. All right. I didn't
so
see that.
So in 14 days, we can declare war. And that means definitely that we don't have enough equipment or artillery or anything that is kind of sensible.
Well, you can almost build one heavy tank soon, though. That will scare them.
One. And with that, I mean one.
Yeah.
So, we're done with this. And it seems like we have to finish puppet or own them. Okay, then I will do this one.
Yeah, while do some passive good ones.
While just waiting for us to... Or waiting for... While killing them. So, I want this large front. You should be very careful because, well... I want to lose as little equipment as possible.
Yeah, have them just push.
While you guys should be pushing in just straight away with the blitz order. Basically do the real deal. Because I don't think...
There's not much defenders here.
Exactly. Because they are being occupied right here.
Yeah. You might want to watch out a bit.
Ah. We split the front and ruined the blitz order.
Oh.
But we can just right-click.
I mean, there's no defenders, just... Just roll it.
So our brave first woman air division. Yeah.
Woman air division. Where tell your careful guys up there to take this area as well.
I think this would basically fall when the rest of the nation falls. But we can do this. So. Yeah, we just walked into the capital. Volga Volga is a Russian firm comedy directed. Oh, so a comedy movie. Increases our political power by 20.
Sweet.
Let's grab the other capital.
I mean, we have state-controlled cinema now, so I assume South everything we put out is good.
South African Federation declared war on Union of South Africa. So, one more civil war. Ah. This is crazy. Ooh, faith in nation.
All right. I guess we have to pick this one. I think after that, I have to actually run.
But,
so,
you said...
We're also dropping some frames for the Twitch stream, so it might be a good place to stop and continue next week.
I think we have to decide on this event first.
Fair enough.
Yes, faith in nation. Our government religious policy has been popular among other own people and abroad. They show how faith can bring order and stability to societies in a chaotic world. there are various of political groups. Okay.
So which
operate. They can be useful. Who it is that directs Russia's foreign policy? Ban them. Okay. Holy Russia say lead the faithful, give them official support. Kinda. And everyone hates us for it, including our own population.
Yeah.
But Holy Russia, I kind of like that. We declare a holy war on the...
Yeah, I mean, they're trying to form an international brotherhood of Orthodox nations.
Yeah. But it's kind of
it
also...
could lead to international complications, but on the other hand, that's probably where we're heading anyway.
Or we just say, anyone is trying to control it except us, ban them.
Kind of like official support here. I feel like we kind of sided with the church already, so like let's go for all kinds
but we didn't give them an official post in our government. We just said it's our state religion.
Yeah,
maybe
I think Holy Russia. Let's go Holy Russia.
Okay, I will follow you this time.
Yes,
come on. Yes, bring down this nation. We have to take some territorial gain to be able to recognize itself as a true Russian empire. Really, what's left?
Yeah.
They control 30%. So it's some victory point somewhere that we're missing. Or don't they count this as fully controlled states? And you go right here. And let's also put everyone on very aggressive stance now.
Yes.
Since we just have to take more land, apparently.
I think so.
Oh,
there is a victory point.
Please go and grab that one. And you, you're just cleaning up more land. Oh, god
damn. We gotta be pretty close now.
I thought lagging decided. No.
81%.
So it's basically just take more land. Oh, no, yeah. You're not sneaking by and grabbing your any back territory.
Oh dear.
The music is really just upping, let's go.
Yeah. Strat, redeploy those guys down. Oh, I guess we can take that last province. So. There we go.
And I'm just going to tell them actually do this too. God, help that division. Cult personality is now done. Actually, yes, attack right there. And support them.
Yes.
Are you done right here? No, you're not. Oh, we took that at least.
The chat says that the music goes well with Orthodox death squads.
Boom! There we have them.
Alright.
We're of course going to take all states because it's our land.
Yes.
41,000 equipment, so we're plus in equipment now.
Yeah.
A lot. But was it bad equipment? Yes, yeah. It was.
Also, if you read the dev diary today, you know that we changed that stuff now.
Yes.
So you actually get it on capitulation as well, which is great for big colonial stuff.
Yeah. But I guess this is the first episode.
The first. Ending. And we shall continue to expand the Tsar's might.
The next week. And
the Orthodox Church, apparently, as well.
Yeah. But, yeah, really cool events, lots of history. Yeah. Oh, well, alternative history. And, I approve.
Yes, good stuff so far.
I really look forward to the expansion mod. Just imagine if
they change. I think we're going to have to try this again at some point to see what happened with how we managed to dodge the Civil War there.
Yeah. If you like this, tune in next week.
Yeah, or download the mod and try it yourself until next week.
No, they need to watch us play it.
Yeah. I think we have a slightly newer version too than what's on Steam.
Yeah, the Fall Core edition.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you guys for joining us and join us next week.
All right.
Bye.
See ya.